girls I've loved before. The first time America met Julio Iglesias, he was singing this song. It was a single that hit number 5 on the Billboard Hot 100 and helped him earn more than $1 million for a week's worth of concerts in less than a day. Europe, though, had already discovered this Spanish star. The former Real Madrid footballer had already scored a number one hit in the UK with Cole Porter's Begin the Begin. Some 3 decades, 80 albums, and more than 2,600 gold and platinum titles later, Julio Iglesias is still wooing multi-generational crowds of thousands. Staying power underlined by the 300 million albums he's sold in 14 languages and the Guinness World Record for best-selling male Latin artist in history. This week on Talk Asia, Julio Iglesias returns to Hong Kong and opens up about his family, letting go of his first love, and why he has no intention of giving up the mic just yet. Julio Iglesias, welcome to Talk Asia.
Oh, well, this is exciting for me to be first talking with Asian after being in Hong Kong.
You've been to this region many times over the
many
years.
Many times.
And it seems as though Asia loves you.
Well, it seems that I love Asia because I came so many times too. I was in Hong Kong the first time in 1971. Since 71, I've been in Asia, all over China. I think for generations already.
Yeah, what is it about this region that you thought way back then was also so important for you to have a presence, for you to be here?
You know, first I was married with an Asian girl. We had 3 kids. And that was the first time that I really understood my passion for the Asian people, no? And so that moment, I developed a very much interest in what happened in Asia. I follow up every year. And it's exciting because I always thought that the communication between Asia and the Western countries was not enough. And suddenly, I feel that it's incredible what happened today between Asia and the rest of the world.
Hmm. You also sing in various Asian languages, Japanese, Mandarin.
Bad, very bad.
But you do sing.
I sing in Bahasa, I sing in Tagalog, I sing in Mandarin, I sing in Japanese. Because I try, you know, when you have an opportunity to do a duet with that beautiful artist in Asia, you do it. And it was a great experience because you had to communicate a passion in a language that you don't speak. Mm. And it was attractive. I like it very much.
You've been in this business and performing for so long now. What would you attribute your longevity and success in this career
to? I'm old already.
No, you've been able to hold people's attention for a very long time.
No, you know, I told you before, you know, then my need is the passion. I know then there is not another way for me to survive. But I can't help falling in love with you. There is something then I discovered through an incredible accident that I had. And through that moment, life came back with the lights. And since that time, I start to understand that music and the passion for music was my life.
Have you always been in control of your career? Because this is an industry where an artist doesn't always have the control. Have you always been in control over what it is you want to do, how you want to sing?
I would like to control more, you know, because control in a way is shows a discipline for a professional. I can't control what I like. I can't control what the people likes, you know, and which is a great match, you know, to be not sure that what you're doing is really correct, because he put much more emphasis in what you're doing. But to be in control is not very much correct in arts. I think that vulnerability, to be vulnerable in front of the people, is much more attractive to anything. I think that is the most attractive thing that an artist can have.
Do you feel nervous?
No, I feel excited, not more nervous. I feel something, you know, I feel a little insecure sometimes, most of the time. But once the lights comes and the music starts, something changes. You know, you can have an incredible headache, you can have a bad stomach, you can have any pain, and after you go on stage, everything changes. You go back from the lights, you go to the dressing room, and the pain starts again, the arthritis,
yeah.
Whatever happens.
When you look at the songs that are being played out today, you've sung some of the most, you know, strong and powerful ballads, love songs there are. Do you think music today has changed, that those kind of strong ballads aren't there anymore?
Oh, it's difficult to say that, because there is great young artists all over the world. And the time today is different, but there is great artists, like there were great artists 50 years ago. It's interesting, you know, you go to Van Gogh and you go to Barcelona, or you go to Miró, or even you go to Picasso, and you cannot say who is better, Van Gogh, Rembrandt, or Picasso. So in music, it's exactly the same.
Tell me about that road that led you to playing for one of the best teams out there, Real Madrid.
The chains are always flowing. Every time I try to say, the winds of change continue blowing, and they just carry me.
You've had some incredible duets with some of the biggest names in music, whether it's Dolly Parton, whether it's Frank Sinatra, Willie Nelson.
Willie Nelson, yes.
To All the Girls I've Loved Before, which is the song that catapulted you into the United States.
I think so. It was a very different situation, you know, to play with a guy like Willie, a natural with the long hair, and short pants, and go to Austin and found him, and I said to my producer, I remember, I don't think I can make it, I don't think. And you know, it was such an unusual duet that the people react wonderfully. And also Willie is a natural, you know, he's an incredible guy. So the song works very much. So when I go to customs, every place in the world, they say, how many girlfriends you had? And I said, a lot.
Is that what people always ask you?
Well, the girls is something that is very interesting, because they know I love and I respect women since I was very young.
Yeah.
But to all the girls I loved before, it has an attractive word. You know, all the girls I loved before.
Is it true that when you were younger, you couldn't get into your school choir, that the priest at your school said, don't think about singing, you should do football instead? Is that true?
Yeah, well, it's a long, you know, every time in the school when you're very young, you go to the chorus line to see if the priest take you there. And I remember the piano, the priest was playing the piano and said, hey, Julio, come here. And come on, go, you go play football.
What did he say when you did make it, when you actually became so successful, and he was the one that said, no, forget it, don't play football?
There is something which is a reality, which is you don't need to be the first in the school to be the president of the country. You don't need to be the best, most incredible voice in the world to be the one who connects with the people. You don't need to be the best in anything to improve yourself until the limits.
So how do you connect with people? How did you find that connection back then when you were just starting?
I think that still today, me talking to you or talking when I'm in my own life thinking, I think that passion commands my life. Without passion, nothing relates to the others. Because passion is an expression who doesn't have any frontier. That's why even singing in Spanish, I sing in the first time when I came to China. And the people didn't understand the words, but maybe they understood what I wanted to tell them.
The emotion.
More than that. Emotionally, you can cry and you can laugh. Mm. But the passion overpowered the emotion, for sure.
So before singing, the passion that you had was football.
Football.
Tell me about that road that led you to playing for one of the best teams out there, Real Madrid.
Well, I was not good, I told you before. I was young first. I was 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. I played juniors, the amateurs. And I was good in that age because I played in a good team, but I was not really a super crack, you know, Casillas, or I play goalkeeper. But I was a very enthusiastic sport guy. And I was strong and disciplined. So I knew that I would never be really a great player, because great player, I was the time with Stefano Puskas, Gento, the most incredible Real Madrid in that time was in the, you know, in the years at the 62, 63, 61, the best team in the world at that time.
What do you think it was about the game of football that you loved?
Well, you know, you feel 50,000 people in the stadium, and it's something when you go in the grass, is the magic start, and you feel like you are something else, you know. You and all the dreams that you have for years come back in a reality, and you are in front of so many people playing a match. I cannot compare now, because the question will be for you maybe, what you will be prefer, what you would like to be, a football player or a singer? A singer. Why? Because I can sing until the end. I will not be able to play until the end.
What kind of a father do you think you are?
To be an uncle.
How do you feel when you're on stage?
When I am on stage, the first impression when I'm in my dressing room, just dressing and looking in the mirror for the first time maybe all day, in that day, and I ask, how are the people, no? And when I start to dress, it feels like I changed completely my system, and I realize I'm going to be with an audience. I'm going to make love to them. They're going to be back to me. And the objective is to be correct, to be perfect.
It came to you singing in a very dramatic way. You had a car accident. Mm-hmm. Tell me about how that happened. Tell me about that day when your football career comes to an end.
I was 19, 20 years old. And my father gave me a little car, and I was coming with two friends of mine in September from a little party. I'm not drinking at all. I was not drinking. Now I drink a little wine, but at that time I couldn't drink nothing. But I was a little in a hurry, maybe. And it was in a curb, and we jumped around, and we almost killed ourselves. Yeah. I get paralyzed completely in a compression in my nerve system. And I start for 2 years and a half, 3 years in recuperation. Somebody gave me a guitar, and suddenly I discovered an attraction to music. My voice was a little voice. My voice changed through the years so many different ways. And I sing like a little, you know, like a little boy. But I have interest in to know how will be to discover another subject. So I went to a contest. I won the contest. I was lucky. And through that moment, then, when I won the contest, I realized that maybe life was giving me another opportunity.
So you, through discipline, through hard work, you regain your strength. You win a major competition, a singing competition. What did your father and mother say about this? Because you were studying to be a lawyer.
Yeah, I'm a lawyer. Yeah, I finished my career. Yeah. So my father was a very special man. My father was a liberal all life. And he believes in me. He saw me as a doctor in my recuperation. He showed me walking hours, swimming hours. Mm-hmm. He showed something that he didn't realize before when I was, because I was very normal, like everybody. But I had the accident. I became empowered little by little. So I showed to my father, of course my mother, but as a doctor, my father doctor, then I could really reach my normal life again. So my father believes. My father said, he wants to be a singer. So be a singer.
You have eight children?
Eight.
What are the...
Eight children is a lot of children.
What are the traits, characteristics of you would you hope to have passed on to them? And what do you hope they don't get from you?
Oh, so difficult. You know, when you have eight children, I know they're going to see this program, you know, and they will be sitting and they will say, what is Papi is talking about? Okay, I have a generation, which is Enrique, Julio, and Elizabeth. Incredible kids, very incredible. Half Asian, maybe the people doesn't know, half Asian and half European. The other generation, I had more time to explain that. There are five kids, 16, 14, twins, 12, and 6 years old. The 6 years old is a magician because he put together life.
Oh.
It's accommodate the others. It's an angel, beautiful person.
What kind of a father do you think you are to them? When you look at the first... from your first marriage, the three children from your first marriage, to the ones that you are that you have now as well, is there a difference to the kind of presence?
There's many. Yeah, I was a baby when I had my first three kids. You know, the reality is, you are in the show business. You travel in. If you ask me straight, have you been a good father for the first generation? I would say no, because good father is. He goes to many things. He goes to the school. He takes the kids to the school. He asks for the lessons. I never did that in my life.
Do you regret that?
No. Because it was my time. It was my life. And thanks that time, they have the time for them. Because the lights, if I keep, I share with them. And I don't think that Julio or Enrique in that moment, we'll have that chances and that opportunities without my absent in the house. So I don't feel guilty.
When your sons, your first two sons wanted to get into this industry that you're in, the music industry, how did you feel about them perhaps wanting to follow in your footsteps?
That's a good question, because I never expect Enrique or Julio to be in show business. Never. Never, because it doesn't happen, as you know very well, in the life of an artist to have kids who follow the steps so strong. Enrique is a superstar all over the world. I can be your hero, Now, when I talk to my kids, when I see the kids, it's not very frequently because they are all over the world. Mm. I don't even know. You ask me what is Enrique Julio now, I don't have any idea. Maybe tomorrow, yes, but I don't have any idea. So now it's different. When I talk to them, the conversation goes to father and kid, nothing related with show business.
When you look at your career now, do you think about, because the audience has grown with you.
It's getting old.
Some, but do you think about younger audiences too? Is that something that you aim to?
It depends on the country, you know, because when I play Brazil, when I play Europe, I have 20 years old. I play 20,000, yeah. 30,000 people, young generations. In that world, I have the three generations. It's another world, it's another life, you know. I can play for 20 years old people and the 60, 70 years old, the grandfathers, the mummies. It's incredible that, because it's a lot of passion in, yeah, that three generations. When I saw Frank Sinatra, when I see Tony Bennett, when I see even Mick Jagger, Paul McCartney, 70 years old, 80 years old, go on stage. You have to have a passion who goes over the brains and the body. If not, you cannot make it.
So maybe in 20 years we'll see you still performing.
I hope to see you again in Talk Asia. I'd love to be here.
It's been an honor for us.
Thank
Julio
you.
Iglesias.
Thank you so
Thank
much.
You so much.
Dios, para los dos, nació de alma.